Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment. He is the 293rd pontiff of the world's most ancient Hindu organization, Madurai Adinam.
Nityanandaya swagatam, anandanubhavaswadam, sarvaroganivarakam, vande papa vinashaktam. Nityanandaya swagatam, nityamuktam nirvikalpam, dhyana loka pradipakam, vande shantam.
सदाशिवसमारंभां ज्ञानसंबंधाचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां.
रियल कर्म योगा मीन्स कंटिन्यूअसली वर्किंग, being creative, not only without even asking why I should be creative and working for so many hours without even thinking. Understand? When you are creative, all the non-mechanical parts of the brain awakens. The moment you think, why should I be creative? You are back. You are a human being. The moment you ask, why should I work? Why should I be creative? You ask for salary, you are a worker. You are no more God. You fall from the state of God to the state of human being. Patita, fallen one. One of the great thing you can say greatest thing in the world is being creative, not only without asking why should I be, not even thinking why should I be creative. You are very breathing becomes creative when you don't even think why should you be creative. Loss of intensity, spirit, honesty, how it happens? Let me give you the postmortem report. Unfortunately, never the postmortem was done so that the future deaths can be avoided. Now I am doing the postmortem. Why the spirit, the intensity dies? First reason. Not having spiritual freedom. I tell you, the fellows, whether they are 30 rupee per day or 300 crore per day, you don't have 5 hours of your time. I am not even asking for 5 hours, even 1 or 2 hours of your time dedicated for spirituality. No, you don't have. One more very funny thing. Not dedicating or devoting time for that spiritual freedom, you call it as a freedom. I tell you, dedicating few hours of your day to the inner search and the development of the highest consciousness. And first thing, you need to understand the importance. Second, you need to be convinced. Third, after convincing and you accept that system and routine, 1 or 2 days, even if you slack, you should be forced into that routine. That is what I call spiritual freedom. Not having the spiritual freedom is the first reason. Second, when you look around, if others are losing the spirit, inspiration, justifying your loss also, seeing, oh, he is lost, losing, he is losing, he is losing. Oh, this is the way it seems. What is the wrong? I can also lose. Justification, because the other person has lost the inspiration, is no way going to be making your inspiration loss as right thing. Understand? These two are the major reasons, two reasons why the death of inspiration happens, death of honesty happens. Death of integrity happens. Intense action based honesty. That is what exactly I'll translate. Here the word yogaha means intense action based honesty. The science of intense action. Inner awakening with intense action. Intense action based honesty. Intense action based integrity. If that is not there, that is getting lost, be very clear. Something is really, really, really seriously wrong in you. Inspiration, integrity, honesty, intense action. I tell you, this is life. Intense action should not become second priority to anything in your life. Whether money, pleasure, luxury, Nothing should take the first priority. An intense action cannot be second priority. Intense action based integrity, intense action based honesty has to be the first priority, because it is qualitatively responsible for your all goodness. Quantitatively good for your goodness. Like if you have 2 car, good. If you have 2 house, good. If you have 10 house, more good. So there are many things, if the quantity is added, good for you. But the intensity, intense action based honesty, by the very quality, good for you. Its very existence brings every auspiciousness to you. If you are living intense action based intensity, understand, you are giving me joy. Intense action based honesty, that yoga, that only gets lost again and again and again. It's like a hide and seek game. Intense action based community, honest communities contribute so much to the world and to themselves. If the intense action based honesty is missing, all corruption, all dilution, all poison gets accumulated. Anti-social thinking and anti-humanity thinking settles. They become source of perspiration instead of inspiration. This knowledge, this great intense action with honesty and intensity was alive, this spirit was alive, as long as it was being properly getting transmitted from father to son, father to son, father to son, by the rajal sages, the raja rishis. When some sons did not receive that knowledge, the chain got broken. That is where the intense action based intensity, this great knowledge, science of inner awakening was lost. The science of having health, wealth, leadership consciousness, radiating the intense life and living in your body and mind, the science got lost. Science of yogic body and Vedic mind and enlightened living got lost when the disciple was not ready to receive.
Nitya Kriya, restoring Hatha Yoga to the world. A series of healing yogic processes revealed by Paramahamsa Nityananda to care and cure for diseases and disorders. Practice Nitya Kriya and awaken your Kundalini energy. To find out more, visit www.nityananda.org/nitya-kriyas.
Man who lives in the eternal consciousness, Nitya Ananda, and allows his body and mind to work according to its nature, is centered on eternal consciousness. He is called Karma Yogi. But the man, out of jealousy, out of envy, out of comparison, who jumps, enters into the social conditioning, social rut, the same routine of rat race, is called Karmi. The difference between Karmi and the Karma Yogi is only one thing. The man who is driven by jealousy is Karmi. The man who allows the eternal consciousness to drive him is called Karma Yogi. All you need to understand is only this one word: without envy, anasuyanto, without jealousy, The moment you start thinking, oh, he is having all those things, he is having all those things, you become mad. If a neighbor brings AC into his house, your house temperature increases. Your house temperature increases. One more thing, when we do things out of comparison, we do all foolish things. Our intelligence stops working. Our intelligence completely stops working. When you start comparing, intelligence stops working. Please understand, every one of you are unique. There is no need to compare. There is no need to compare with other person. You are unique. The main problem is you compare only with the nearest persons. 5 inch up and 5 inch low. Only with that person you compare. You don't compare yourself with Bill Gates, do you? If you compare, even God cannot save you. That is different. You don't. You compare only with your neighbor. You compare only with your colleague. You compare only with your brother. You compare only with your sister. The problem is not even failure. Your worry about the failure is the problem. That is why you don't compare with the unreachable goals. You compare only reachable goals. You compare only with immediate persons. Understand, this comparison is what is driving you crazy. Again and again and again brings the whole social conditioning on you and eats away your whole life. Your whole life is eaten away by this one maya called comparison. Your whole joy, ecstasy, bliss, the very bliss or the ecstasy of living is swallowed by this one maya called comparison. Two things. There is something called comparative reality and something called existential reality. If you build your life based on existential reality, you will never suffer. If you build your mind on comparative reality, you will be continuously suffering even at the time of death. Not only at the time of death, even after death. Don't build your inner space on comparative reality. Let your inner space be built on existential reality. Let you accept the life as it is. If you build your life on existential reality, you will live your life blissfully in eternal consciousness as Karma Yogi. Let your inner space be built on existential reality, not on comparative reality. The whole essence of Karma Yoga. So understand, because of all these reasons, drop your attachment to the purpose, drop your attachment to the goal and live the happy life, live the life blissfully, you will achieve the supreme. Usually people ask me, Swamiji, if you say that life is purposeless, why should we work? Let us lie down. Who will give me food? I tell you, you can never lie down. You may lie down for next 4 or 5 days because you always go to this extreme. Now the pendulum is in this extreme. If you take the hand, it will go to this extreme. Maximum 1 week you will be able to lie down. After that, you can't lie down. By your very nature, you will start doing the work. By your very nature, you will start doing the work. All I mean, when I say life is purposeless, I am not asking you to just lie down in your home. I am asking, let your body and mind work without disturbing your inner space. You don't have to sell your inner space to have outer place. You don't have to sell your inner bliss to have outer comforts. By your very nature, your body and mind will work. Just if you keep quiet, that is enough, they will function beautifully. Just if you get out of your system, that's enough, divine will get in. All we need to do is just get out, divine will get in. By very nature, your body and mind knows the right thing, but you never trust your body and mind. You never trust your body and mind. You always trust your ego, which finally dumps you in the dustbin. But you never trust the body and mind. Be very clear. Your body and mind by nature will do the work. All you need to do is keep quiet, relax from your ego. Don't think your inner space is needed for the outer work. The person who understood what is nitya and what is anitya, the person who understands what is eternal and what is ephemeral and relaxes into the eternal, is always in eternal consciousness. He always resides in nitya ananda. A man who relaxes into nitya ananda and does his job, does his work, he is karma yogi. Just relax into your inner space. Automatically you will be guided. You will be guided. You always think, if I relax in my mind, thinking that life is purposeless, how will I know which is right and which is wrong, Swamiji? How will I know which is right and which is wrong? Please be very clear. The more you worry about which is right and wrong, you will not do any mistake. You will commit blunders. The person who worries which is right and which is wrong continuously will commit only blunders. He will never commit mistakes. The person who doesn't worry, who never bothers, he may do small mistakes. But the person who continuously worries will never do small mistakes. He will commit big blunders. And I tell you, to take this jump of not worrying needs courage. Even if you do one or two mistakes, what is the wrong? Taking the risk and jumping and start living without worrying is what I call dhiratva, courage. Courage of entering into the spiritual life. When you take the jump, you will do naturally one or two small mistakes. Don't worry. Putting up with that mistake is what I call tapascharya. Tapas. Tapas is nothing but accepting the small mistakes which you do when the conscious transition happens in your being. When you move from ephemeral consciousness to eternal consciousness. When you move from worry to bliss. When you move from asatya to satya. You will do one or two mistakes. You will fall and rise. Just like a small child when it tries to walk. It will always fall once or twice. Just because of that, can you say, don't start walking? No. Even if it does one or two small mistakes, it has to stand up and start walking. That one or two small mistakes, once or twice falling and trying to stand up, is what is tapas done to learn how to walk. Same way, when you start living without mind, in the initial level, you may commit one or two mistakes. Don't worry. That is tapascharya. That is tapas. Have courage and just enter into the zone of no mind. Enter into the zone of eternal consciousness. Simply start living. Realize the purposelessness of the existence. Decide today onwards I will live without worrying, because life is too small to be spent in worrying. Life is too small to be spent in worrying. Life is too short to be spent in worrying. So never bother, never worry about your goals. Just drop the goals. The moment you understand the beauty of purposelessness, all the wounds which you have created in your inner space will be healed. You will fall into the abyss of eternal bliss. Shraddha does not mean faith. Shraddha means faith plus courage to execute that idea. Courage to experiment with that idea is Shraddha. Courage to experiment that idea is what is Shraddha. Man who executes these teachings with Shraddha, courage to follow. Why we need courage to follow? Small story. One born blind man goes to a doctor and asks, "Doctor, will you help me to have my eyes?" Doctor says, "Don't worry, I'll do some operation. You will have your eyes. After that, you can walk without the stick." The blind people, they always carry a stick to feel the road. "You can walk without that stick." Now the blind man asks, "Doctor, I understand you will do an operation. I understand I'll have my eyes back. But I don't understand, how can I walk without stick? How can I walk without stick?" By and by, the blind man forgot the stick is from outside. He started thinking, stick is necessary even for walking. But till the operation, till he gets his eyes, he has to have Shraddha towards the doctor's words and lie down in the operation table. Same way, I tell you, just live without mind, just live without purposes and goals. You will be able to walk without stick. Stick is worrying. But you can never think you can live without worrying. By and by, worrying has become your part. So we can never imagine we can also survive, we can be alive without worrying. Please be very clear. Never think because of you, your life is going smoothly. In spite of you, it is going smoothly. Understand? Never your life is going smoothly because of you. In spite of you, it is going smoothly. The moment you have the courage to have Shraddha to these teachings and start living, dropping the purpose, only then you will realize you don't need stick to walk. You don't need stick to walk. Once you enter into the being, the depth of your being, you will enter into a totally different dimension. Whatever now you think as spiritual life or material life, both will lose its meaning. You will enter into a new dimension of life. For example, can you explain for 4-year-old small child the life of marriage? Can you explain what is life to a 4-year-old child? You can't. He can't understand. But he can understand only toys. He can understand only dolls. He can only play with toys. Once he reaches the age of 25, naturally he will be able to understand what is life. Automatically toys and dolls will drop him. Do you feel that you are missing your toys? Do you feel that you have renounced your toys? No. The moment you grow, you start experiencing a different dimension of your life. When you experience a different dimension of your life, automatically the small things drops you, and you drop them, they drop you. Not even you dropping them is important, they dropping you is important. You dropping smoking is not important, smoking dropping you is important. When you enter into your being, when you enter into the purposelessness of life, the whole so called material life and spiritual life drops you, and you enter into a different dimension of life, a new dimension. That is what I call quantum spirituality or eternal consciousness. You reach the eternal bliss. You start living in eternal bliss. Now you may have a serious doubt. How can I walk? How can I live without worrying? I tell you, your doubt is nothing but the same doubt this blind man is asking. How can I walk without stick? You cannot convince the blind man you can walk without stick till he gets the eyes. Only after he gets the eyes, he will be able to understand he doesn't need stick to walk. Same way, only when you reach the being, you will understand you don't need worries to live. You don't need mind, you don't need worrying mood to live. Till you reach the being, you need to have Shraddha. Till you get your eyes, you need to have Shraddha and lie down in the operation table. You need to allow the doctor to work on you.
Ingenious. Your child learns and experiences the true science of Vedic tradition. Notice a measurable increase in your child's performance. Daily yoga and powerful meditations. Innovative art processes based on life solutions. Activities that bring Vedic culture to life. For more information and registration, email us at ngenius@nityananda.org or visit www.innerawakening.org.
Let me explain exactly what is Karmasu Kauchalam. Please understand, the solidified emotion, it may be Matrubhava or Sakabhava or Dasabhava, Vatsalya Bhava or Mathura Bhava or Mahabhava, the solidified emotion is Bhava Samadhi. But when that solidified emotion is no more separate from you, becomes part of your very existence, consciousness, that is what I call Karmasu Kauchalam. Means, see, what is solidified emotion? If you are in Bhava Samadhi, means you will see everything as Devi. If you are in Bhava Samadhi with Krishna, you will see everything as Krishna. So much of sweetness will be there by the remembrance of Krishna. When that sweetness becomes part of your action, without even remembering Krishna, just by your action, if you are going through that same intense sweetness, that is what is called Karmasu Kauchalam. Efficiency in action. Efficiency in action means never being tired of action. any action which makes you tired will make you old, will bring you disease. Your action, when it does not make you tired, when it goes on inspiring you for more and more and more, then you reach the space yoga karmasu kauchalam. The big problem with a solidified emotion is you can spend any number of years with it and finally you can lose it also. You will not go forward. But once that yoga karmasu kauchalam, that happens, it becomes sagaja samadhi. Unless you show efficiency in action, perfection in action, the emotion you are going through, the bhava samadhi you are going through, will not become part of you. Bhava samadhi you go through will become part of you only when you take responsibility, only when you bring perfection in action. Joy in action. Efficiency means the action should have its effect on outer world and the inner world. It should be like a double-edged sword. The action should be creating desired result outside and desired result inside. That is what I mean by the word efficiency. If I have to give an example, morning you get up and do yoga. The action of doing yoga should create the desired result in the outer world, means the body becoming healthy. And same way it should create the desired result in the inner world, creating a positive pattern or a positive mental setup, which is purpose of yoga. So all action, same way, if you are creating a relationship, it should create the friendly relationship and it should bring the happiness and fulfillment which you are supposed to have in your inner space through that relationship. So efficiency means the effect of action in the outer world and in the inner world. Unfortunately, whole humanity is established in laziness. Now I am telling you the truth. Perfection is not measured by the result of the action. It is measured by the way you are acting. Understand? The quality of the action, not the quantity of the action, not the quantity which happens because of your action, but the quality of your action. Only when the quality is not there, you will have time to measure the quantity of the action. So perfection is not measured by the result of the action, it is measured by the quality of the action. But I tell you, when the quality is there, the quantity also will follow, even though you don't bother about it. It's like you walk without bothering about the shadow, but the shadow follows you. Same way, in the quality, in the kaushalam, in the efficiency, you walk and it follows. The quantity also follows you.
Sacred Art Store. Nityananda Sacred Art Store. A storehouse of spiritual products from Vedic culture. Find all your needs for yogic body, Vedic mind and end living.
a one-stop shop for spiritual products and gifts. www.sacredartsstore.com or email us sales@ngalleria.com.
I tell you, whenever you are in confusion, the best way to get out of confusion is start doing intense action. Start creating. Take the decision which expands your consciousness even though it pains. Always decide for fulfilling what you stand for. Whenever you are in confusion, dilemma, take up responsibilities. Go on expanding. Life is a play. Life is a joy. Hard work has its own strength. Hard work in hostile situation makes you a leader. The irresoluteness that is born and is cherished in heart due to non-understanding, stand up and gain superiority through intense action. Please understand, being is long-term value creation, doing is short-term performance. That's all. If there is a problem in doing, there is a problem in being. If there is a problem in being, there will be problem in doing. These two are not two separate things. What is long-term value creation? Understanding and internalizing, spiritually realizing the importance and the method of the short-term performance is long-term value creation. Understanding, internalizing, philosophically realizing the importance of short-term performance is long-term value creation. Why you should perform in short term? Why you should immediately deliver? Why you should be productive? I tell you again and again and again, human beings suffer with the concept, why should I be productive, responsible, working? This is what way it is going to add to my spiritual life. Arey, you don't understand. Only when you perform, when you create, take the responsibility, your own understanding about you raises. Your own idea about you raises. There is no other way. Only when you take the responsibility, contribute and make difference in others' lives, either directly or you do the actions which makes difference in others' life, you have a right understanding about you. What is long-term value creation? It is nothing but creating the right understanding and internalization. I can give you hundreds of examples where if the right understanding, philosophical realization is not there, the delivery also won't be there. Even a small action like morning, you get up and make coffee for yourself or for your family. Have philosophical internalization. Even the reason for that very small act, think and philosophically internalize. Why should I do? What is the need? If you understand that, naturally, as a basic natural evolution process, your mind will start saying, how better I can make this coffee? Understand? By nature, you are a person expanding. If you are not expanding, you are not philosophically convinced, there is something seriously wrong with your inside. Long-term value creation is nothing but philosophically internalizing, understanding, realizing the short-term performance. When you philosophically internalize and realize every action you need to perform, simply the long-term value creation also will happen and the short-term performance will happen. Every day, by your nature, you will ask, how can I better my short-term performance? It is nothing but non-internalization and continue to live with the hypocrisy of non-internalization. I tell you, if you philosophically internalize the necessary for the short-term performance and build the long-term values, even if you are not part of the Sangha or if any fear and greed attacks you, you will not compromise with that. You will go on performing because performing is life. Constant performance raises your frequency more than Ichha Shakti, more than the desire energy and knowledge energy, your creative energy expresses. Please understand, all these nine planets impacts only your Ichha Shakti and Jnana Shakti. If you unclutch your creativity from your desire and knowledge and push it independently, it means whether you feel like or not morning waking up, whether you feel like or not performing, even one small act like a morning making a coffee or tea, connecting it so strongly and internalizing it, it is directly towards life's mission, enlightenment. If you wake up and make this tea and drink this tea, your body will be fresh. You can continue with awareness, your ajapa japa, unclutching, and you will be moving towards enlightenment. That understanding, philosophical internalization, is what I call long-term value creation. How can you perceive the knowledge, Atma Vichara and Karma Yoga, both as one and the same? How is it possible? Because human beings have an innate hatred towards the work, intense action. If somehow they get tuned, they build a pattern of intense action, they develop innate hatred to just sitting and contemplating, exploring themselves. Unfortunately, human beings are always single-sided. They tend to lean to one extreme. Either you move to the contemplation, mental work, or you move to the intense action, physical work. Very rarely people perceive both as one and the same. The key word in this verse, yappashyati sapashyati, I can give you one key to understand the discriminative knowledge and intense action is one and the same. The bridging point is exploring your possibility is samyama. Discovering your own possibilities is samyama. If you are discovering your possibilities by constantly contemplating, you are doing jnana samyama, if you are exploring all your possibilities through intense action, you are doing karma samyama. If you do samyama, either on jnana or on karma, you will understand both are one and the same. I can tell you from my own experience how I was exploring my different possibilities and sharing with the world. If you start looking at my life, from the age of 12, I can say I have started exploring the jnana samyama through the contemplation, exploring and discovering my different possibilities. Please understand, when you explore and discover your emotional possibilities, that ripes into bhakti. When you explore and discover your physical possibilities, you become yogi. When you explore and discover your mental possibilities, it becomes siddhis. When you explore and discover your conscious possibilities, it becomes enlightenment. My body was not capable of continuously working. But I could see very clearly, when I started exploring and discovering my capabilities, my possibilities, now so many extraordinary truths gets directly downloaded into the system without even my effort and comes out. And hours of intense action, work, automatically is happening in my system without even me remembering the idea of tiredness. Forget about controlling or suppressing tiredness, idea of tiredness. The possibilities, when you explore the possibilities and discover, I tell you, exploring the possibilities and discovering the possibilities suddenly makes the zigzag puzzle of life fall in proper way. Maya reveals her true form. The delusion removes its illusion component. If the illusion component is removed from delusion, what remains is divine. It is the illusion component in delusion constantly keeps you deluded. The real solution comes by removing the illusion component, not by acting at those moments. Most of the time, any action you do, you are in trouble. Because the illusion component need to be removed from the delusion. Exploring and discovering your various possibilities takes away the illusion component from the cosmic delusion itself. From the very cosmic delusion, illusion component disappears. It is like in dirty water. If all the dirt settles down, it becomes fresh water. Same way, in the Maya, if illusion is taken away, it becomes Maya. Maya means mother. When the akara of illusion is added, Maya becomes Maya. When the akara of illusion is removed, Maya becomes Maya. Exploring your various possibilities and discovering your possibilities is what I call samyama. When I started my public life, when I started sharing my possibilities with the world, even I did not know so many extraordinary things are going to express through me. Even I did not know the possibilities of me. I only know one thing: whatever I am starting now is auspicious. It will do good to others and to me. I should go on sharing. It is like when the water was slowly getting removed from the well, even well did not know huge Ganga is going to come out of that well. Huge river is going to come out of that well. Even the well did not suspect or expect the river of Ganga is going to come out of it. Well only knows one thing: now whatever is coming out is good for himself and for others. So it went on giving, it went on exploring and discovering the possibilities and sharing. Explore and discover your physical possibilities, that is yoga. Explore and discover your emotional possibilities, that is bhakti. Explore and discover your mental possibilities, that is siddhi. Explore and discover your conscious possibilities, that is mukti.
Nityananda Radio Podcast, Life Solutions on the Go, with enlightening and entertaining segments each week in the form of breakthrough talks, meditation techniques, interviews, and more. Nityananda-radio.podomatic.com.
Action means opening new possibilities in you, opening new challenges in you. Very beautifully Osho says, don't travel in the same path second time. It's a Taoist saying, even it is a wrong path, travel in new path. Even if it is right path, don't go second time in the same path. A little extreme. Life, the juice of life, constantly oozes in your being. The nectar, amrita, constantly oozes out of your being. Only if you explore the new possibilities. I'll define living human being. Living human being should be a person, wake up like a flower, with all courage and strength and confidence to explore the new leaf of life. Explore and intensely, explore so intensely, take such strong risks, by night you should wither away. Fall asleep. Next day morning again, wake up. In the night, if you are not withering away, you have not used all your confidence. You have not used all your courage. By night, you should wither away. means taking all extreme decisions, steps, living in utter insecurity is enlightenment. I tell you, living in utter insecurity is living enlightenment. If humanity is little more evolved, if humanity can tolerate me without organization, means if humanity can receive me without organization, unfortunately, only in an organized way, I am able to deliver my message to humanity. So I have to put up with organization. If humanity is matured enough to receive me without organization, like how Buddha's time, Shankara's time, humanity was ready to receive, listen. If that possibility is there, I will not be sitting in one place with so much of security. I'll walk from street to street. Live in utter insecurity. Show the power of enlightenment to people. Action means morning waking up with a full fresh life. By night, all the decisions you take, risks you take, the confidence you exhaust should exhaust your whole life. You should wither away and fall like a flower. That night you should become manure, support for the plant. Next day morning again, new flower happens. This is what exactly is life. This is what exactly is living. This is what exactly is action. Unfortunately, organization stops you taking that risk. Understand? Exhausting the confidence, that is action. If you have the confidence to jump 7 feet, exhaust that confidence by jumping 9 feet. In every level, every step, exhausting the confidence. See, if you are not radiating extraordinary powers and energies, then all your theories about the spiritual practice, struggle, everything is just your fantasies. Maybe conveniently convincing fantasies. If you are radiating at least one extraordinary power, like you have gone beyond sleep, you have gone beyond hunger, you may eat, but eating is not binding you. You may sleep, but sleeping is not binding you. Same way, 24 hours, whatever may be the situation, the ajapa japa is happening. Something like this, at least one extraordinary power, one extraordinary capacity, only if that is exploding in you, radiating in you, I can say you are seeking as some depth. You are sacrifice as a reason. You are having the courage. You are taking risks. Karma means exhausting your courage by every decision. Every decision make you feel the shoulder pain and exhausted. Oh God, I can't take any more decision. I am going to collapse. Then again, next moment, the next decision you take should make you collapse. I tell you, every time when you stand the decision which makes you feel like you will collapse, your shoulder becomes more strong. It's like workout only. First you use 10 kg dumbbells, you feel you will collapse, you can't handle the pain. But one day you handle the pain and work out, your stamina increases. Next day you can lift 20 kg. Same way, today you take one risk, jump, your mind says, no, I am exhausted, I am collapsing. Handle. Next day you will take stronger risk decisions. Just like workout for body, this is workout for mind. Karma means ability to take decisions which exhaust your confidence. If you are not exhausting your confidence every day, be very clear, your life is going to be like a body which is never moved or made to work. Body which is never moved or made to work, what is going to happen? It will just rust and dust over. Body which is never made to work, mind which has never taken the risk, is one and the same. Body which has never made to work, the mind which has never taken the risk, is one and the same. I tell you, even if you are inside an organization, let your heart be above the organization, not below, above the organization. Above the organization means you don't hate the organization, you run the organization, but you are always free and beyond the organization. You are always free, unbound by the organization. Action, being free from action and inaction. You need to discern all these three. Action, being free from action and inaction. Scope of action is inexplicable. Now I am explaining, understand. The real scope of action means exhausting your confidence, courage to take the decisions which exhaust your confidence. Every day, the decisions you made, the work you did, the work you did should tire your body, the decisions you made should wither your mind. Then you have the yogic body and Vedic mind. Understand? I am defining yogic body and Vedic mind. The work you did whole day, by night your body should be tired and fall asleep. The risks, the decisions you took with your mind should just wither away and fall into the abyss of peace, fall into sleep. Only then you have yogic body and Vedic mind. Any man who lives just as disorganized, lives like animal and dies. Who lives organized, lives like a mediocre human being and dies. Who lives in organization, beyond organized, by exhausting his body through intense work, by exhausting his mind, by taking intense risks and courageous decisions, he lives as God and never dies. Karma means exhausting your body by work and exhausting your mind and confidence by taking risks, risky decisions. Next, 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 next. Play your game always on the edge, never on the safe ground. Always walk on the rope, not on the road. Walk on the tight rope. Always, your whole life will be alive. When I say walk on the tight rope, even if you fall, there will be net to hold you. There will be a net below to hold you. But don't look down and verify whether there is a net or not and then start walking. The moment you did that, the net will not be there, will not be seen by you. It may be there, but it will not fall in your eyes. I tell you, always walk on the tight rope. Never on the road. That is karma. So action, being free from action and inaction, all these three has to be discerned, because whatever you know as the meaning of all these three is too small. Scope of action is inexplicable. Now I am defining the scope of action for you. Please understand. Action means exhausting your body by work, exhausting your mind by taking risky decisions. Scope of action is beyond any explanation. He says, exhaust your mind. I tell you, the constant risky decisions you take should exhaust your confidence, exhaust your courage. Life is for the people who are ready to exhaust their courage. Till you are afraid to exhaust your courage, the stored courage becomes sickness. Stored confidence become cowardness. Understand? Stored confidence, which is not used in action, is cowardness. Unused courage, which is not used in your action, is sickness, disease. Your heart should be beating. Oh, I'm taking the risk. I'm taking the risk. I don't know. But walk. When your heart says, I know I am comfortable, very happy, stop walking. Change the route. It is with this constant beating your heart beats. If not, your lungs may work. Heart doesn't beat. You may breathe, but you don't live. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974-22-033-11. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.